Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome back to Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. So, in the last episode, we got into Dranglea Castle, but we've got some enemies in here that I have to deal with. I have to kill one by each of these doors in order for the door to open, but inside the doors we have, remember the rune sentinels? We've got one of them in each of these doors. Maybe not every door, but at least three of them, maybe four of them had one. And I'm going into the room to kill them because I don't want to fight them out in the main room because the main room has the other guys in it. The statues that will come to life. Okay, yeah, that's right. Neither of them do for that door. This one lights that torch. This one lights that torch. And then I can summon the Phantom or the Shade to help me in here, but not sure if I want to do that just yet. Probably be helpful, but maybe not, I don't know. So I can brute force through them by just continually hitting them. If I get in 5 hits, they're dead. But it's best to not. I'm switching over to that right away. It's best to not push my luck. I think that one, both of them get up. See, I can kill them before they kill me, but I have to heal afterwards then. Seriously? Great, now I have to fight all of those room sentinels carefully to not attract the other ones while I'm fighting one. I'm gonna summon the Shade to help me. But yeah, now all those rune sentinels are awake, or are up, and I have to fight them all without drawing the attention of the others, because all the doors are open now. Did I repair that ring? Yes, I did. Probably should have been wearing it. But I honestly forgot I had repaired it. Now, how am I gonna do this one? I hate when people invade you. I mean, invasions are fine, but when they do something that screws me over like this, I absolutely hate it. And I understand they're not doing that most of the time. They're not screwing you over intentionally, but it still sucks. Sometimes I like to watch those, because those are other players who are going through this area. I don't know if they're going through it at this exact time. I believe that is what it is. It's other players in the area right now. But I could be wrong. All I know is those little, those white phantoms like that. Oh god, did I just open that door? Of course I did. You come down here, so I've got a bit more room to fight you. Crap, okay, I can't block after hitting you twice. Do I want to go into that one right now? I don't think so. I want to go over here first, I think. Oops, got too close. I don't think there was a sentinel behind this one. Maybe there was. No. So all but one have a sentinel behind them. I was cautious of this chest because there was a blood stain in front of it, but apparently I didn't have to be careful of the chest. I had to be careful of the person who was about to invade me when I opened the chest. Run. Get back here. I don't think they follow you back into this hallway. No. That's actually how I normally pick them off once I have to come in here again. Come on. Out here. Out here, please. Of you guys stands up. That one. You've gotta be fucking kidding me. What the hell? I hit him. Why did he not take any damage? You gotta be kidding me. And it won't do me any good to not not restore my humanity because they can still invade you in this one. At least that was my understanding, was that people can still invade you in this one even when you aren't human. Well, I didn't lose anything that time, that's right. But now I have to kill all of these fucking things again. I don't get how that guy didn't take any damage at all when I attacked him. That shouldn't happen. Apparently this is a lot weaker against these. That guy better not invade me again. Although I can almost guarantee he will. Will it put me way too far over, I suppose? Not that far over. So that I can switch over to that fucking smelter sword to take on that guy when he shows up. Anyway, as I was saying, it wouldn't do me any good to not restore my humanity, because in this one you can get invaded while you're hollow. At least I know NPC invaders can invade you while you're hollow. I'm not sure about players, but I have a feeling they can too. Seriously, why the heck would that guy... See, what he's doing here is he's probably hoping for people who are coming in towards the end of the game. Because the end of the game is down there. But that's not what I'm here for. Either that or he just doesn't give a crap and he's here to just kill anyone who comes through. Which I understand playing PvP and stuff, but that's just... Oh crap, I didn't mean to do that. I just drew both of them. I didn't mean to aggro both of them. I was too busy complaining about that guy being a jerk. Are you kidding me? This place was bad last time I came through, but it wasn't this bad. If that guy hadn't killed me that first time in here, I would be fine. If he hadn't invaded me when he did, when I was opening that chest, I would have been just fine. But now all of these are open, so I can't just go in and kill them one by one like I did. Let's head back here for now. Repair my ring. Maybe upgrade some stuff if I can. Hopefully by the time I get back there, that guy will be gone then. Probably not though. What am I going that way for?
Bearer of sea lest.
I don't have a shard, do I? I was gonna say an Estus flask shard and a shard, and it came out a flard. That's not that useful, honestly. Let's do this. Get a bit more carry or equip load. If that guy invades me again, then I'm really not gonna be happy. I mean, I'm not happy as it is, but if he invades again, then I'm gonna be pretty upset. First one of you. You're guarding. Doesn't do any. Are you serious? I was gonna say it doesn't do you any good to guard if I hit you from behind, but what the fuck? Are you kidding me? I apologize for the language. This is just getting ridiculous. Because you don't have enough. First of all, you don't have enough room to fight everything at once. Second of all, there's no possible way you could fight everything at once. And I don't want to just sit here and use my bow to pick off the guys that are the statues, because that would take forever. But I may have to. least some of them. I swear, if that guy freaking invades me again now, I'm gonna be so pissed off. Again, I apologize for the language, but I'm quite frustrated with this right now. Combat in this one is a bit different from in the first one, too. It's a bit weirder. Like, once you start an attack, you have to finish it, and stuff like that. Kind of, you can't cancel an action once you've started it. So if I start an attack and the enemy starts to attack me, I can't start blocking. I'm stuck wide open until my attack finishes. And it wasn't quite the same in the first game. I don't know what was... It was just a little bit different, and it made it easier to fight in the first game. But in this one, it makes it more difficult. The fighting, the combat style is a bit more difficult in this one. A bit more unforgiving, I guess. Plus, I want to say in the first one when you used the Estus Flask, didn't it just fill your life immediately? It didn't, like, bring the bar up a little, like, over time like it does in this one? I don't really have much of an option but to continue forward in the game. If I can move around a bit faster, it'll be easier to do this. Plus, if I can just circle strafe around them, I can end up poisoning them. I guess I'm just gonna have to do one hit and then block, one hit then block. Just pick at them little by little, I guess. I get an opening like that. I mean, that works, but that takes a while. And it gets quite annoying. Please tell me I didn't just aggro both. Nope, just this one. These things are too agile for their size. It's not fair. Something that big should not be able to jump around that much. Can't take as many hits in this armor, but I can move more, which means I'm able to avoid them more. Now if that dickhole invades me again, I'm gonna be so pissed off. Because once or twice is okay to invade the same person, but then when, if you invade them and it's the same person like a third time, don't kill them again. Leave and invade someone else. I mean, that's the way I see it. Once or twice, fine. But if you start invading more than that, that's when it starts to get to the point where it's just too much for people. Unless you can tell the person doesn't mind it. Like some people, if they're standing around waiting to be invaded in an area, because some places are more higher traffic for PvP. Like if somebody's in there and they're clearly waiting for other players to come in and fight them. Like if I'm not out in this area clearly trying to move through it, it wouldn't be so bad, but he should be able to tell I'm moving through here anyway. Maybe not, I don't know, maybe he thinks I'm here for PvP, but I just get a bit frustrated when it happens that much. And different people, I could understand, but if it's the same person, I mean, I know he hasn't come back, but if he does come back, then it's kinda messed up. I'm just kind of rambling on about the PvP in the game. And parts of it I don't like. And one thing I don't like about the matchmaking in this one is that it goes by that soul memory rather than your soul level. So somebody could have, because I've spent a lot of souls on stuff, because my soul memory is about 1.4 billion right now, it looks like. And that's the total number of souls I've had throughout the game, and it happens in brackets based on your soul memory. So there could be somebody who hasn't used it to buy items, who hasn't used souls to buy items, who's just pumped it all into leveling up. And there could be somebody who's like 10, 20 levels ahead of me or something. I don't know how many they would be ahead if they did, but where I'm at a disadvantage with my stats because of it. So that's what that kind of bothers me about the matchmaking in this one, is that it's not based on your actual, what your stats could be around. It's not based on how many stats you've increased with your levels and stuff. Okay, I want to take this armor off before I approach him. I didn't make a whole lot of progress in this episode so far.
Young undead, don't let this curse weigh upon you. We meet a second time. Perhaps you will yet traverse the dark. Young undead, if you truly seek the dark, then we will surely meet again.
and I already know where I meet him, but I kind of gave up trying because the giants kept killing me there. Now, I don't want to go through that area again. I'm going to end this episode right here, and I will try to continue on in the next episode. First.
Bearer of Celeste.
I'm going to level up once more. I want to get under 100% equip load. Then, Sublime Bone Dust, so my Estus Flask will heal me for more. But anyway, I will pick it up in the next episode. Thank you everybody for watching, I hope you enjoyed, and as always, I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.